for the Wildcats. Corner infielders are in. As Sequeira throws the game's first pitch, and it's lifted out to right center field. Battling the sun and making the catch in right field is Hunter Hearn. One pitch, one out. And this game is underway at 6:32 p.m.
Right on the right, Colton Eager.
-73 degrees at first pitch in Huntsville, Texas. Now it's Colton Eager, takes a fastball high. 1-0. Home plate umpire tonight is Chris Booker. Nice off-speed pitch over the outside for a strike. 1-1. Chad Rogers, the first base ump. Chuck Bussey's over at third. He called balls and strikes last night. Eager pops it up, shallow left. Moving towards the line is Clayton Harp. In the shade now, he makes the catch right on top of the left field line. A good start for Gabriel Sequeira. Two quick outs in the top of the first. Now it's Dallin Farkas. Farkas hitting .364 for the year. Three homers, 19 runs batted in. Was 1-for-4 last night. Sequeira hits the outside for a called strike. This is smoked high in the air to left field. Coming over toward the line is Harp. At the warning track, he feels the wall and he makes the catch. A deep fly out from Farkas ends the first inning. A good start for Sequeira. Three fly ball outs for Abilene Christian. We'll stay here for the mid-inning break after a 1-2-3 inning for Gabriel Sequeira. Farkas just missed this one. Harp had it sized up. The wind is not a factor so far tonight. It was blowing in towards from right center field before the game. The flags are motionless now. There's Garrett Hudson. Right-hander getting warmed up. Six-foot-one right-hander out of El Dorado, Kansas. 2-0 with the 5.87 earn run average. Tonight's his fourth start of the year. 15 strikeouts against 6 walks. And he gets the start tonight. Here's the starting lineup for fourth-year head coach Matt Deggs and the Sam Houston State Bearcats. 18-7 on the year, 7-0 in the Southland Conference. Trey Ochoa, Ben Hafner, and Hunter Hearn, the top of the order, followed by Blake Chisholm and Andrew Frege. Clayton Harp hit sixth, Jordan Cannon hit seventh, moving up one slot in the order after his grand slam last night. Jack Rogers gets the start at first base, and Eric Bonner, another start in center field after a very good game yesterday. The first six hitters for the Bearcats are the same as last night. Bonner and Rogers both stay in the lineup. Bonner and Cannon, I should say. Rogers gets the start, his seventh of the year. Trey Ochoa will lead things off. A rare 0-for-5 for him last night. He did score a run and he stands in batting .326 on the year. First pitch is a called strike. Off the mitt of the catcher, Zach Mauser. Garrett Hudson, the right-handed pitcher. Has his sign and comes home. Another fastball just outside. Had a good chat before the game with Abilene Christian head coach Britt Bono about his right-handed pitcher. says he's primarily a fastball guy. Is it right back through the middle of base hit? Ochoa, a single up the middle, and the Bearcats off to a good start. 12 hits for the Bearcats last night as they score double-digit runs, winning 10-1. Ben Hafner now will stand in, a senior transfer from Buffalo. 1-for-4 last night, 3 runs batted in. Had a 2-run single in the 7th and a sacrifice fly in the 3rd that tied the game. Fastballs over the inside, a called strike. Hudson's fastball sits in the 88 to 90 mile an hour range. He'll hit 90 later in the game, so he gets stronger as the game goes along with his fastball. Ochoa leads from first, he's not running, and it's lined out to left, a base hit. Opposite field approach from Hafner, who quite often goes the other way. And a good start for the Bearcats. Their first two hitters, both with singles. Now it's Hunter Hearn. Hearn 2 hits last night, including an impressive opposite field double to right center field. That was part of the 3-run rally in the 3rd. The Bearcats were down 1-0 and scored the game's final 10 runs. Third baseman Watts is up a bit. First baseman Donahue plays behind the back runner Hafner. First pitch is in the dirt. 1-0 on Hearn. Hearn hitting .320 for the year. 5 homers, 23 batted in. In addition to Hudson's fastball, he throws a slider and a changeup. A big spot here for Hearn to give the Bearcats the lead in the bottom of the 1st. Big swing from Hearn, he fouls it back. Coach Britt Bono told me that a big factor for Garrett Hudson is rhythm. He needs to find his rhythm. If he does, he'd be very effective. Works up in the zone and down in the zone with his fastball, like an elevator. 1-1 the count. Runners get their leads. Now they go as Hearn squares to bunt and takes a strike. Mauser did not throw down to 3rd. A double steal for the Bearcats. Ochoa to 3rd, Hafner up to 2nd. That's Pack Baseball, Hunter Hearn, a number 3 hitter with 5 homers on the year, squaring to bunt with the double steal on. 1-2 the count, back to the windup from Hudson. He comes home and a slider is bounced towards 3rd, and that's a fair ball. Now they have Ochoa in a rundown. He is tagged out, and Hearn's going to hustle up to 2nd. He is out! Slight hesitation from Hunter Hearn, and that cost him. Maybe he thought if he got a throw down to 2nd, it would allow the back base runner Hafner to score. But a base running mistake, he stopped about 2/3 of the way down. If he had simply gone to 2nd, he probably makes it easily. So the Bearcats lose 2 outs on the play. Ochoa out at home trying to score. Hearn out trying to take it 2nd on the fielder's choice. Now it's Blake Chisholm in from the left side. Big cut, he swings and misses. Call it a fielder's choice, 5-2-4. And catcher Mauser tagged out Ochoa as he tried to score from 3rd. Fastball misses outside. One and one on Blake Chisholm. Coach Bono said that Garrett Hudson's a very good competitor on the mound, trying to escape this first inning jam. Chisholm, a high chopper to the right side. Donahue has it, flips to the pitcher covering, and the inning is over. Hard flip from Donahue to Hudson, who got there ahead of Chisholm. Bearcats with two hits, but they don't score in the first. After one inning from Huntsville, no score.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer, and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does Bear Bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Gabriel Sequeira back to the mound for the second inning. He'll face Donahue, Salazar, and Munoz in the Abilene Christian order. Donahue swung at the first pitch in the second inning last night and homered off Wesniewski. Fastball's up and in. That gave Abilene Christian a 1-0 lead. High chopper foul. And it's 1-1. Speaking with Britt Bono, the head coach of Abilene Christian, before the game about the approach of Donahue, who swung at the first pitch in three of his four at-bats last night. He says, Donahue's a smart hitter. He lets a lot of his hitters do that, be aggressive early in the count at certain times of game. As that one runs inside, two balls and a strike. That was Donahue's second homer of the year. Stands in hitting .350 for the season. 2-1 the count. Fastball is outside. Spoke with pitching coach Jay Sirianni about Gabriel Sequeira. Foul back. Coach Sirianni said Sequeira's made a move this year compared to last year. Last year oftentimes sat 84 to 86 miles an hour. Now he's more in the 85 to 88 mile an hour range and he can hit 90. And he walks him. Misses low with the fastball on 3-2. Donahue's aboard. He had two of the seven hits for Abilene Christian last night. Now it's Robert Salazar. .341 hitter on the season. He's not bunting and a fastball is up and away. Salazar batted down in the order last night and was 0-for-3. Hit seventh last night, batting fifth here in game two. Good fastballs there for a strike. Coach Sirianni told me that Gabe Sequeira also added a cut fastball. That's very effective against right-handed pitchers. It gets right in under the hands of the righties. See if he tries it here. Another high fly ball, this one on the infield. Frigier backing up, and the shortstop puts it away. Every out so far, a fly ball out for Abilene Christian. Now it's Matt Munoz. Munoz was the leadoff hitter last night. 1-for-4. He stands in batting sixth here tonight. Pitch misses low. We saw the changeup there. Coach Sirianni has said Sequeira's changeup has come along the last couple starts. This is roped out to right center. Hearn racing out there. He plays it on a hop, and up to third will go Donahue. Life in the Abilene Christian dugout. A walk and then a single, and the Wildcats have runners at the corners. Good swing, a pitch in against Munoz, and he rips it out to right center. Here's Zach Smith. Smith was 1-for-4 last night. An Abilene native and freshman stands in. Runners at the corners. Middle infield double play depth. Corners are up for the Bearcats. Indecisive swing, and he went around. Sakara also has a two-seam fastball, which he'll use at times. This is wide towards second. Ochoa will go to second for the force out, and Abilene Christian takes a 1-0 lead. Donahue scores from third. Munoz out at second. Smith gets the job done with the fielder's choice.
Third baseman number 39, Seth Watts.
Now Seth Watts with two outs and Smith on first base. That's the first college RBI for Smith. Fastball to Watts, misses low. Another freshman in this Abilene Christian order. Fastball hits the outside. Watts hitting 250 for the year. One homer, 10 runs batted in. Watts was 1-for-3 last night, batting in the number 2 position. Good pickoff move from Sakara, but back in with the dive is Smith. Rogers came off the bag for that throw. That's unconventional. Good pitch, but it missed just low. You want to let the ball come to you. The ball can travel faster than you can. So Rogers coming off the bag did not help with the pickoff, but at least he caught the baseball. A 2-1 pitch, lined out to right field. Hearn broke in, now he breaks back and he'll make the catch. Hunter Hearn, no problem looking back into the sun. Watts is retired and the inning is over. Abilene Christian strikes first. A score here in the second on the RBI fielder's choice from Zach Smith. 1-0 Wildcats going to the bottom of the second.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does Bear Bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like a BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Andrew Frigier will lead off the second inning for the Bearcats. Frigier, Harp, and Cannon do up. Frazier, one of the stars of this Bearcat team. A junior hitting 297 for the year. He and Hearn, the only position players that have started every game. Frazier. Frazier hammers it out to left field. Scott towards the line, racing back. He reaches up and makes a spectacular catch as he crashes into the wall. What a play from Scott. Taking away extra bases from Frazier. Fearless from Derek Scott. A rope off the bat from Frazier. Scott got a good break. Made the leap right at the foot of the warning track and carried into the base of the wall and held on. A web gem from Derek Scott. Now it's Harp, takes the first pitch for a strike. Spectacular defensive play from Scott in left. Check swing, roller towards third. Watts charging, has it, throws on the run. Nice play. Two quick outs. And now it's Jordan Cannon's turn.
Catcher number 25, Jordan Cannon.
Cannon, a big night last night, a triple shy of the cycle. His first career grand slam, also the first grand slam this season for the Bearcats. Takes a fastball for a strike. Had a chance to speak with Jordan before the game about being the full-time catcher this year after being more of a backup 2 years ago as a freshman. It's roped towards short. Salazar has it across the diamond in time. Cannon retired. I'll tell you more about what he said as the game rolls along. Two innings in the books from Huntsville, Texas. Abilene Christian with a 1-0 lead.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom. Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
I know my life is going to be in a better place after I graduate because of the donors who give me their endowment each year.
The Bearcat Champions Fund, building champions.
One nothing Wildcats as we start the third inning in Huntsville. Gabriel Sequeira. It's looked pretty good in the early innings. Can be tough to judge a pitcher who is allowing pop-ups and fly balls. I would say more often than not a good sign when you're allowing fly balls, but with Gabriel Sequeira's stuff and that cut fastball in under the hands of right-handed hitters, it might be by design and they're not able to drive the baseball. So far, so good. One run allowed, and he's upset the timing of these ACU hitters. It's Zach Mauser to lead off the third. 9-1-2 in the Abilene Christian order. Fastball high. Mauser 1-for-2 last night. Some very fine plays behind the plate at catcher last night. Another fastball's up in the zone. Mauser 2-for-17 on the season. He's in there more for his defense, which has been very consistent this year. Sequeira comes back and it's in there for a strike. Now the 2-1, fine foul. Sequeira working quickly. Swing and a miss, a high fastball. Mauser down on strikes. First punch out for Gabriel Sequeira. speaking with Coach Matt Deggs before the game about Sakara. He said he's deceptive. Fastball comes at you harder than it looks coming out of the hand. And there's a fastball for a strike. And he said at the college level, that is one of the most important things as a pitcher is what it looks like coming out of your hand. Foul back. 0-2 on Scott. He swung at the first pitch his first time up and popped out. For Sakara, good deception on his fastball. And one of the keys, according to Deggs, is how it comes out of his hand on the changeup. It's head out to right. Hearn has it in the alley, and there's one away. Deggs says for Sakara to be successful tonight, needs to stay on top of that changeup. Not push it towards the plate, but good action from his hand as it comes out. Here's Colton Eager. Flew out to left field his first time up. Having a good freshman year at 355 on the season. Swings and fouls it back. Sakara, a sophomore, making his sixth appearance of the year. And his fifth as a starter. Hits it out to left. Harp in the alleyway will make the catch. A 1-2-3 inning for Sakara, who's retired the last five he's faced. To the bottom of the third from Dawn Sanders Stadium. Wildcats lead the Bearcats 1-0.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does Bear Bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like a BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite, hold true.
A good looking demeanor in that Bearcat lineup. One thing Coach Deck stresses is come to the ballpark with the same attitude every day, winning and losing. He wants his players to be the same guys, and he has liked what he's seen from his Bearcat team this year, 18-7 overall. Perfect 7-0 in conference play. A start for Jack Rogers, and the freshman picks a fastball low. Rogers came off the bench last night, 0-for-1, and scored a run. Good opportunity for the reserves to get some action last night. That's over the outside, a called strike. Rogers fouls it off back of third. Rogers drew a walk last night. It was one thing that was very pleasing to Coach Deggs was his entire lineup, including the reserves, drawing walks. Bearcats drew 8 free passes last night. Fastball high. And after the game, Coach Deggs told media that it was perhaps the most patient his team has been all year. He loved the approach of his ball club. Up and down the order, the starters, and then the batters off the bench. Good slider is in there for a called third strike. First strikeout for Garrett Hudson. Now Eric Bonner. Bonner had a very nice game last night. Gets rewarded with another start tonight. His average up to 333, 6 hits and 18 at bats. Fastball's there for strike one. Bonner 3-for-5 with the run scored. He also made some fine defensive plays in center field. That fastball misses. 1-1 on Bonner at the top of the order, and Trey Ochoa on deck. 24 pitches so far for Garrett Hudson. The big righty lines and throws. Good eye from Bonner. Watches another fastball miss. It was interesting talking with both coaches before the game, Coach Matt Deggs for the Bearcats and Britt Bono of Abilene Christian. Deggs was very pleased with the patience of his team. Bono lamenting the free passes issued by his pitching staff last night. Big swing and a miss from Bonner. Coach Bono said, this Bearcat team is so good at the plate, you cannot give them free outs. And free trips to the base paths. Another fastball, a very good take from Bonner. The count is full. 8 walks issued by Abilene Christian last night, including 4 from the starter, Brock Barger. Full count on Bonner. Lined out to right center field, that's a base hit. Nice at bat from the freshman. Looked at several close pitches and then went the opposite way. Nice approach from Bonner. Coach Degg said he's been waiting to find Bonner at bats, but you have to earn them. And so one thing he said about the reserve players who got at bats last night, they don't come easy, they don't come for free. The players earn them on merit. Very deep Bearcat team. Ochoa takes the first pitch for a strike. Ochoa singled his first time up, part of the double steal with Hafner, but was ultimately thrown out at home, trying to score on a soft ground ball to third off the bat of Hearn. Bonner, good speed at first base. And he'll go on the ball in the dirt and take seconds. Excellent read from Eric Bonner. 2 stolen bases last night, and he gets a very good secondary lead and jump here. No hesitation from the freshman. So much of base running is just decisiveness and instincts and not hesitating. Bonner, very aggressive there. It has scored a wild pitch. 1-1 to Ochoa, and it's line foul. Britt Bono, the head coach of Abilene Christian, lamented not only the walks, but the free passes and the errors from his pitching staff last night. 2 hit batters as well. The 1-2, high chopper to the right side. Tough play, Donahue has it. Good cover at first base from Hudson, the pitcher. And Bonner moves up to third. Two outs for Ben Hafner. Hafner, an opposite field single his first time up. He loves going the other way. Line drives to left center field. Upstate New York native transfer to Sam Houston State from Buffalo. Good block from Mauser on the pitch in the dirt. The Bearcats had a good run scoring situation in the first. Second and third, nobody out, but they did not score. Hunter Hearn bounced into what turned into a fielder's choice double play as he was out trying to take second after Ochoa was thrown out at home. Haefner lines it down the left field line towards the bullpen, foul. 1-1. The priority tonight for Britt Bono and the Abilene Christian Ball Club is throwing strikes, not giving the Bearcats free passes, playing good defense behind them. And I think for Coach Matt Deggs and the Bearcats, more of the same. He loved the patience at the plate. He said, if we can walk more and more this season, it'll be a very dangerous ball club. Hit to the right side, tough play. Donahue has it. He'll throw pass for space. Coming in to score is Bonner up to second. Goes Haefner. It's 1-1. Well, Coach Bono has raved about Donahue and his baseball IQ at first base. This was a difficult play. Sometimes as a first baseman, you can go too far. He may have done that. Might have been an easier play for the second baseman, Smith. But he rushed his throw to first base and threw it past the pitcher, Hudson. Now it's Hunter Hearn with two outs. Good slider, but it gets away from Mauser and a free 90 feet for Haefner. Back-to-back mistakes from the Wildcats. And now Donahue will go to the mound to talk with Hudson and the catcher Mauser. By the way, it was scored an infield single for Haefner. And then he took second on the throwing error by Donahue. It is an RBI for Haefner. And that was scored a pass ball against Mauser, allowing Haefner to take third. One and 0 on Hearn. Big swing and he fouled it back. Tenth run batted into the season for Haefner. And his fourth RBI of this series after three last night. One ball and one strike. Slider bounced to short. Salazar across to Donahue and the inning is over. The Bearcats get a run with two outs. And after three innings, it's 1-1 in Huntsville. Fourth inning from Huntsville. Dallin Farkas, Riley Donahue, and Robert Salazar due up against Gabriel Sequeira. First pitch hit high and deep out to left field. Harp at the warning track will settle under it and make the catch. Just missed from Farkas for the second straight trip to the plate. Last time hit it deeper onto the track in dead left field. That was out to left center. Two deep flyouts from Farkas. Now it's Riley Donahue. He walked and scored in the second. Having a productive series for Abilene Christian. First pitch taken for a strike. Foul back by Donahue. Gabriel Sequeira, a very good athlete, played Olympic development soccer before committing to baseball and football in high school. Oh, a three-sport star. Slow chopper to the right side. Ochoa charges, fields it, throws to first in time. Not an easy play for Ochoa. He started in shallow right field. A bit of a shift against Donahue, but he charged it and made the play look really easy. You can see Donahue off balance with that swing. Seven straight retired by Sequeira. Now it's Salazar. First pitch is outside, ball one. Salazar 0 for 1, popped up his first time. Sequeira also a very good kicker on the football team in high school. Nice changeup is called a strike. He kicked a 45-yard field goal in a game in high school. As the 1-1 misses inside, he also kicked a 55-yarder while at the University of Texas football camp. Outside 3-1. Sequeira went to Cy Creek High School in Cypress, Texas. 55-yard field goal. You're not kidding around from that distance. Comes back with the fastball, and the count is full. Here is the payoff pitch. Foul back. One top of the fourth. Sequeira trying to for a second straight 1-2-3 inning. The sophomore lefty to the plate, and it's bounced to short. Frigier charging, fields it hip high, and throws over to first. Sequeira has settled in. We go to the bottom of the fourth. 1-1 in Huntsville. Fans enjoying themselves between innings. Friday night baseball on Easter weekend. Normally in college baseball, this is the start of a weekend series, but with the holiday, most teams played last night, including these two. The Bearcats won 10-1. Blake Chisholm takes a fastball outside for ball one. Chisholm grounded out to end the first inning. Chisholm 2-for-4 last night with an RBI and a run scored. Hitters count as Garrett Hudson comes home. Pop foul towards the Bearcat bullpen. 41 pitches now for Hudson. Coach Britt Bono said if Hudson could give him four strong innings, he would take that. And he might go past the fourth. No activity in the bullpen. Bounce to second. Smith boots it, and his throw is late. A mistake from Smith. On a routine ground ball to second. Credit Chisholm hustling the whole way out of the box. An unearned run for the Bearcats last inning to tie it up, and now the second error of the night against the Wildcats. Here's Frigier. Blocked behind home plate by Mauser. Frigier hit a fly ball out to left his first time up. It was a spectacular catch running into the wall from the left fielder Scott. Stands deep in the batter's box, and it's 2-0. Second straight hitter's count for the Bearcats. Good cut from Frigier, he's fouled it back. 37 errors committed on the season now for Abilene Christian. Their opponents have committed 45. Great swing from Frigier, but 37 is a high number. The Bearcats have committed just 24 errors in 25 games. Here's the 2-1. Frigier fouls it off down the right field line. That was the fourth error of the season against Zach Smith, the ACU second baseman. 2-2 the count on Frigier. Chisholm's running and then he stopped and Frigier fouls it off. Chisholm had me fooled. I thought he was trying to steal second, but he put on the brakes. Did not fool our camera operator behind third. 2-2 the count. Chisholm gets his lead. Frigier ready from the right side. And Hudson steps off. Chisholm 2-for-2, stealing bases this year. Bearcats as a team have stolen 25 on the year. Their opponents have swiped just 16. A good take from Frigier. His teammates appreciate, you can hear the hollering from the dugout. All the Bearcats on the railing on the third base side. One of the great things about college baseball, the life in the dugouts, the traditions, with all the teams. Chisholm runs, and Frigier hits it out to right field. In the ballpark, eager in the alley, makes the catch. Frigier's 0-for-2.
Left fielder number 47, Clayton Harp.
Now Clayton Harp stands in. Harp grounded out to third base his first time. Chisholm leads from first. And it's fouled back. Activity has begun in the Abilene Christian bullpen. A right-hander is up and working. The game plan for Bono, 4 innings. If he can get through 4, I think it would be mission accomplished. Abilene Christian pitching staff has been ravished as of late, heavily used, playing in some high scoring games. Hit well out to center field. Munoz racing back, still back, he makes the catch. Chisholm retreats back to first. Nice play in center field. I'm at Munoz. Jordan Cannon will stand in. Cannon grounded out to shortstop his first time. I was starting to tell you about my conversation with Cannon before the game, about differences as a junior starting catcher compared to 2 years ago when he was backing up Robbie Rojas. Slider stays high, 1-0. He joked that he was a little bit wide-eyed as a freshman. He's learned a lot in the last couple of years. He said last year, pitching exclusively out of the bullpen, he learned a lot from the other pitchers and pitching coach Jay Sirianni on how to approach the game, adjustments on the mound, and he's carried that to this year behind home plate. Chisholm bluffs a steal, and Cannon fouls a pass. Matt Deggs in the third base coach's area. Coach Sirianni said they like throwing to Jordan Cannon. He said that he really builds a rapport with every pitcher on the mound from their very first pitch in each game. Chisholm's not running, and a slider's in the dirt, blocked nicely by Mauser. Cannon a grand slam last night, really broke it open. Made it 7-1 for the Bearcats in the fifth inning. From 3-1 to 7-1 in one swing. Chisholm runs. Swing and a miss, throw down to second, and Chisholm takes second. That's Pack Baseball. The designated hitter and cleanup man steals second. Matt Deggs loves athleticism. With athletes, you can make plays like that. Now Chisholm in scoring position. He's now 3-for-3 on the year when trying to steal. 2-2 the count. Strike three, a fastball, and Cannon is caught looking. Nice work from Garrett Hudson. He's gone the prescribed four innings, and he strands Chisholm at second. Now to the fifth from Huntsville, 1-1. Easter weekend in Huntsville, Texas. My name is Matt Peterson, delighted to be here. It's 1-1 between the Bearcats and Abilene Christian. Gabriel Sequeira, as I mentioned, grew up in Cypress, Texas. To Side Creek High School. He was also coached by David Clyde, the former big leaguer and Houston native. Clyde was the first overall pick in the 1973 Major League Baseball draft. And he would play five seasons for the Rangers and the Indians, but had to retire early because of arm and shoulder injuries. Clyde at one point compared to Sandy Koufax. Clyde, after retiring, has continue to coach in the Tomball area and Cyprus. And he coached Gabriel Sequeira in high school. Not a bad pitcher to learn from. Change up from Sequeira, misses low. Matt Munoz, a nice play in center field. In the bottom of the fourth, taking away a possible hit from Clayton Hart. Bounces this one high towards first, it's a foul ball. Munoz singled to right field his last time. They 1-2 pitch. Head out to left field. Clayton Harp moving to his right. And there's one out. Nine in a row retired from Gabriel Sequeira. That's the eighth fly ball out, coaxed by Sequeira tonight. Sequeira last pitched against DBU last weekend. As that pitch hits the outside for a strike. Took the loss, gave up 8 runs, 7 earned on 9 hits in 4 innings. Misses inside with the fastball. Very good Dallas Baptist lineup. They took 2 of 3 from the Bearcats. Coach Derek said it was great competition. They would play them every year if they could. Change up is outside. But a good test for the Bearcats and a humbling experience, losing 2 of 3 at home to the perennial postseason club, Dallas Baptist. Fastball is high. Before the loss against DBU, Sequeira 3 straight wins. 2 of them on the road in conference play at Texas A&M Corpus Christi and at Lamar. Pounds the strike zone and the count is full. 6 innings at Corpus Christi, 7 innings at Lamar. And there is the second walk issued by Sequeira. Nice at bat from Smith. Smith, an RBI ground out his first time up, which gave ACU a early lead. Seth Watts will stand in now, 0 for 1. Flew out to right field his first time. Here comes Matt Deggs out of the Bearcat dugout. Activity in the Bearcat bullpen. Riley Gossett up and working for Sam Houston State. One of the keys for Matt Deggs about Sequeira tonight was strike one, getting ahead of hitters. 2 walks issued, which is rare for Sequeira, who had walked 4 total in 27 and two-thirds innings all season. And 2 of those walks came against Wright State at the end of February. Sequeira had walked 2 in his last 4 starts. Deggs talks with his sophomore lefty and returns to the dugout. Had bluffed a bunt. Some howls from the ACU dugout. They thought that was ball one. Seth Watts, 0 for 1, flew out to right field. And they call a balk against Gabriel Sequeira. And up to second goes Smith. Yeah. Sakara asking the umpire for why the balk was called. And by the indication from Chad Rogers, maybe Sakara never came to a stop. You saw him making the motion almost like a Ferris wheel rolling. Or like a pitcher asking for more signs. Sakara missed badly on that one. It's 1-1. Zach Mauser on deck in the top of the order. Again, Sakara asks Rogers about something after that pitch. Sakara reads the sign. An inside target. And he misses outside again. Two balls, one strike. 57 pitches so far for Sakara. Head out to right field. Hearn hoping for a play, but that's gonna land in the Abilene Christian bullpen. Bullpen's empty, so we'll either see another inning from Garrett Hudson or the right-hander who was up and working is coming in. Two balls, two strikes. Seth Watts at the plate. Fouled off. Sakara, eight appearances as a freshman last year. One start. Now a mostly regular starter as a sophomore. A 2-2 pitch. Fastball stays high. Fifty-nine pitches so far for Sakara, 37 strikes. Has his sign from Cannon. Now the 3-2. Just a bit outside. Back-to-back walks from Sakara. Now it's Zach Mauser. Never want to walk anybody, but back-to-back freshmen down in the order makes it even more costly for Gabriel Sakara, and that's the end of his outing. Was cruising right along, had retired 9 straight hitters, but lost Smith and then walked Watts. And the sophomore lefty's night is over. The new pitcher for the Bearcats is Riley Gossett. He takes the mound when we come back.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools, for nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar, so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
What does it mean to be Southland Strong?
It's not just big wins.
It's success in the classroom.
And being engaged with service.
Family. Passion. Integrity.
Overcoming adversity.
Hard work and dedication.
Bettering people around you.
Striving for excellence.
Leadership and competition.
On our campuses.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Riley Gossett into the game for the Bearcats. Seventh appearance this year for Gossett. He's been very good. 2-0 with a 2.73 ERA. seventh appearance overall. He's made five as a starter. And like Sequeira, very good command. Only three walks issued against 24 strikeouts. Like Sequeira, Riley Gossett is from Cypress, Texas, a baseball hotbed. Gossett pitched at Cy Ranch High School. Sequeira at Cy Creek. Now, Gossett missed all of last year due to injury. An opportunity to pitch like Seth Ballew out of the bullpen tonight behind Gabriel Sequeira. First pitch misses low. Three pitch mix for Gossett, a fastball, a slider, and a changeup. Zach Mauser at the plate struck out. His first trip to the plate against Gabriel Sequeira. Two on, only one out. 1-1 the score in the fifth. Nice pitch, 1-1. Gossett's tried the slider on the first two pitches against Mauser. Top of the order, Derek Scott on deck. Two walks ended the line for Gabriel Sequeira. Another slider foul back. Almost a blueprint of last night's game for the Bearcats. They fell behind 1-0 and have come back to tie it up. Hayden Wesneski went four innings before Seth Ballew relieved him with one runner on in the fifth, and Ballew went the rest of the way. Gossett comes on with one out in the fifth. A pitch outside, 2-2. Gossett could go the rest of the way. It's a long ways away, but he has pitched into the seventh inning before this season. A 2-2 outside. ACU suddenly very patient at the plate here at the bottom of the order. Smith and Watts both walking, and a full count here for Zach Mauser. Smith leads from second, Watts off of first. And another walk, a borderline fastball is just low. Bearcats were very good as a pitching stack last night. Only one walk issued. Wesneski, the starter. Ballew did not walk a batter in relief. Four free passes issued now for the Bearcats. Base is loaded, one out. And it's chop foul, pass first. By the way, the three walks issued by Gabriel Sequeira, a new career high. And never walked three in a college game before tonight. Derek Scott has flown out twice. The second time tonight he swung at the first pitch. He did it in the first when he flew out. Couple fly balls off the bat of Scott tonight. High fastball and it's fouled back, 0-2. Gossett's last time out was against Dallas Baptist last Saturday. 4 1/3 innings, 6 hits, 2 runs, no walks, and 3 strikeouts. Gossett from the windup, but before that, Scott calls time. Colton Eager on deck. No balls and 2 strikes. And he got him to chase. He stayed up in the zone and Scott could not lay off. Big strikeout for Riley Gossett.
Right fielder number 8, Colton Eager.
Now it's Colton Eager, 0-2. Has twice flown out to left. Gossett stays in the windup. Nice slider over the outside. 0-1. Smith is at third, he walks. Watts at second, he also walks. Mauser at first, he also drew a base on balls. The 0-1. Slow chopper back towards the mound. Gossett will let it roll foul. Gossett was hopeful it would roll foul, living slightly dangerously. I think that was the smart play. If he fields it, it's going to be a very difficult play at first. He almost had to let it roll foul, and it did. 0-2 on Colton Eager. Three walks have loaded the bases for the Wildcats. Gossett ready on top of the mound. Has his sign from Cannon. High chopper to second. Ochoa has it on to first, and the sign is retired. Nice work from Gossett. He walks Mauser, but a strikeout and a ground out leaves the bases loaded. To the last of the fifth in Huntsville, 1-1.
Okay, let's get back down to Jessica for the H&B over-under contest.
All right, I'm here with Jake, and he has a chance to win a $5 gift card from H&B. If he can guess that the price on the board is over or under the actual price of the item. Are you ready? All right, the product today is H-E-B Yellow Mustard. This is your second. It's $1. Do you think the real price is over or under? Got a guess? He's going with under. Let's see if he's correct. And he is. Congratulations, Jake, and thank you to H-E-B.
The new H-E-B in Huntsville is open 24/7. And is proud to feature curbside grocery pickup. Visit hebtu.com to take advantage of the curbside service. Shop, pick up, and relax.
Welcome back to Don Sanders Stadium. Some little leaguers enjoying this one. A 1-1 ball game as we go to the bottom of the fifth. Garrett Hudson has gone further than his coach had planned, so exceeding expectations. Brent Bonnow told me before the game, if Hudson could give him four innings, he'd be very pleased. Well, he'll start the fifth inning on the mound for Abilene Christian, and he'll face 8-9-1 in the Bearcat order. Rogers, Bonner, and Ochoa do up. Hudson ended the fourth inning, striking out Jordan Cannon on a fastball. Cannon was caught looking. Big swing and a miss from Rogers. Now Rogers getting his cuts in. He struck out looking to begin the third, his only at bat tonight. Rogers, a freshman, gets his money's worth with his swings. Fastball is outside, 1-1. 58 pitches so far for Garrett Hudson. 39 strikes. Activity resuming in the ACU bullpen. A righty up and working. Nice slider at the knees for a strike. Rogers, a freshman out of Klein Collins High School in Spring, Texas. Swing and a miss, good fastball. Rogers down on strikes for the second time today. Well, that's an indication of what Coach Brent Bonnow told me before the game. His fastball gets better as the game goes. And he just blew it by him. Bonnow told me that Hudson can hit 90, but usually later in games. That looked like one of his best fastballs tonight. Here's Eric Bonner. First pitch swing and he fouls it back. beautiful backdrop here at Huntsville. At the end of March, sun setting behind third. Slider swung on and missed. Hudson now getting some swing throughs against the Bearcats. Bonner badly fooled. Slider ripped out to left center field. Munoz on the run will make the catch as he falls backward. Excellent play. Very good defense tonight from Abilene Christian. They've made two errors, but that was the second spectacular defensive play. As Bonner saw another slider.
Miller Lite. Hold true.
Look a little more difficult than it was falling backward, but nonetheless, a nice play for Munoz. Bonner, one for two. He singled to right field his first time. Now it's Ochoa. First pitch swinging, grounds it right to Watts, who bobbles it, recovers, throws to first, not in time. Third error of the game from Abilene Christian. Two of the three errors for Abilene Christian have come with two outs. The two out error in the third led to the run. As the runner goes, the throw down to second is not in time. Stolen base for Trey Ochoa. Ochoa steals on the very first pitch. His fourth, now make that his fifth steal this year, his second steal tonight. He's now 5 for 6 on the season, part of a double steal in the first inning. 0-1 the count. Hafner takes a called strike over the outside. And I should say that the error in the third did not lead directly to a run. Hafner had an infield hit and took second on a wild throw, so the run would have scored anyway. 0-2 the count. The only run against Hudson so far was earned. That's in the dirt, gets away from Mauser. Ochoa stayed at second. He looked a little disappointed himself that he didn't try for third. Simply reading body language. I think he wishes he was more aggressive. One and two against Hafner. He laid off the 0-2 pitch in the dirt. Hunter Hurd on deck. Hit out to shallow right, long run for Eager. Still Eager coming in, and it falls. Bearcats take a 2-1 lead. Ochoa scores from second on a bloop hit from Ben Hafner. Well, right off the bat, it felt like it was gonna be a difficult play for Colton Eager, who was very deep and right. And Smith did not get out there in time. Now, not an error, but a very catchable ball for Abilene Christian, and the Bearcats capitalize once again with two outs. The run is unearned. Hafner has his second RBI tonight, and the fifth RBI of this weekend series for Ben Hafner. 2-1 Bearcats. Hunter Hearn stands in. And he ropes it high and deep to left. Scott is back at the warning track and will make the catch. Maybe off the end of the bat just a bit from Hearn. The Bearcats strike again with two outs and they have their first lead of the ball game. We go to the sixth in Huntsville. 2-1 Sam Houston. Christian, an up and down season, trying to get a win here in Huntsville. And they trail 2-1. The Bearcats showing some resilience. Single runs in the third and the fifth to take the lead. Dallin Farkas will lead things off for Abilene Christian in the sixth. Farkas, Donahue, and Salazar. 3, 4, and 5 in the order against Riley Gossett. Gossett out for his second inning out of the bullpen, and he gets a swing and a miss. Farkas, a big cut. Farkas 0-for-2 has hit deep fly balls his first two trips, and both were caught. Swing and a miss there from Farkas. Two challenge fastballs from Gossett. Gossett walked Mauser, the first man he faced, but then he struck out Scott and coaxed a ground ball from Eager to end last inning. He stays high with the fastball. It's 1-2. That left the bases loaded and might be a key at bat in this game if Abilene Christian cannot come back, as they had the bases loaded and only one out. Fastball misses low. 2-2. The book is now closed on Gabriel Sequeira, the starter for the Bearcats. 4 1/3 innings, one run allowed on only one hit, but he walked three. Slider is outside. The count is full. One strikeout for Sequeira. 9 fly ball outs, 3 ground ball outs. He throws 61 pitches, 38 strikes. And Farkas walks. Well, Gossett had him 0-2. I'm sure frustration for Matt Deggs, Jay Sirianni, and the entire Bearcat coaching staff. The Bearcats have now walked 4 of the last 6 Abilene Christian hitters. Dangerous Riley Donahue stands in. Good power from the left side. And he takes ball 1. Donahue swung at the first pitch of the second inning last night and homered out to right. Want to know the count. And he hits the outside, 1-1. Tonight, Donahue has walked and scored and grounded out to second. A big lead at first base for Farkas. He is running, and it's bounced right to the shortstop hole. A hit and run well executed. Hafner was up at third base, so his range was limited. Donahue, nice piece of hitting going the opposite way. A walk and a single. An activity beginning in the Bearcat bullpen. A lefty up and working. Robert Salazar might be asked to bunt here. So far, he's popped out and grounded out. Corners are up. A late show of a bunt, and it's bunted foul. Cannon was quick to react. Perfect. Jack Rogers, the first baseman, is up. Third baseman, Frazier. And the Bearcats often do this in bunt situations. Frazier, the shortstop, will move to third. Third baseman Hafner will move to short. Pickoff play to second, diving back in safely is Farkas. Last night it was Cryer, the third baseman, moving to short, Frazier moving over to third in a similar instance. 0-1 the count. Salazar is not bunting. He hits it back towards the mound. Perfectly positioned is Hafner. He only gets one out. Could have been a double play, but it was bobbled by Hafner. And the Bearcat defense in good position. They get one out. Both base runners advance. Farkas up to third, Donahue up to second. Salazar retired, he's 0 for 3. Matt Munoz, the center fielder now. Middle infield is back, the corners are up for the Bearcats. First pitch is foul back. Now Rogers is about halfway at first. Hafner is about halfway at third. Frigé is returned to his shortstop position. Time called. Well, the Bearcats would concede the tying run if it's up the middle. The corners might have a play at home. And there's a pitch out. Nothing doing as the 0-1 pitch misses up and away. You do not see the Bearcats pitch out very often, but I think Abilene Christian scratching for runs against Sam Houston, I don't mind the call. I think it's pretty wise. I think a bunt very well could have been on there. Swing and a miss. Good pitch in the dirt. One ball, two strikes. Here comes Gossett. Right back towards him and past him. Fielded by Frigé, throws on the run in time. Nice play from Frigé. The tying run scores for Abilene Christian. Farkas in from third. Donahue moves from second to third. Very nearly fielded by Gossett, and if so, he might have had a play at home. Munoz gets the job done with the RBI ground out. Now two outs for Zach Smith. First pitch swinging, hits it out to left. Clayton Hart moves in a bit, and the inning is over. Abilene Christian ties it up. We go to the bottom of the sixth in Huntsville. 2-2. Garrett Hudson back to the mound for Abilene Christian. He'll try to complete six innings. And as I said earlier, Abilene Christian head coach Britt Ponnelby told me before the game, if he can get him four innings, he'd be very pleased. He might give him two more. A back and forth ball game. The Bearcats, 10 unanswered runs from the third inning on last night for a 10-1 win. Abilene Christian scored first in this game, a run in the second. Bearcats single runs in the third and the fifth to take the lead. ACU has tied it up with a run in the top of the sixth. Chisholm, Frigé, and Hart two up. 4, 5, and 6 in the Bearcat order against Hudson. And here's Hudson's 70th pitch of the night. First pitch swinging popped up by Chisholm. Shallow left field, Scott coming in, the left fielder makes the catch. Chisholm 0 for 3 tonight. He reached on an error and stole second as last time. I don't think the Bearcats have been quite as patient tonight as they were yesterday, when Matt Degg said may have been the most patient he's seen his Bearcats all season. This was Frigier's at bat in the second, and what a play out in left field. Derek Scott running into the wall as he takes away extra bases. Frigier flew out to right field his last time. He's 0 for 2. The 1-0 pitch. A looping slider, almost like a curveball. That time Hudson took something off it. 72 pitches so far and 52 strikes. The Bearcats have yet to draw a walk tonight. They drew 8 free passes last night. Fastball hit back through the middle into center field, a base hit off the tip of the glove of Garrett Hudson. Frigier with his first hit of the night. Simple approach from Frigier. Shortened up and went right back to the box. Clayton Harp is 0 for 2. His last time hit it well to center field. Nice play made out there by Matt Munoz. That was the 6th hit of the night for Sam Houston State. We've also benefited from 3 errors. Harp takes a fastball high. Garrett Hudson the set, and the pitch. Frigier is running, and he'll make it into second easily. Well, the Bearcats may have identified something in Hudson from the stretch. Frigier stole that one off the pitcher. Great jump from Frigier. Very athletic baseball player. Can play really anywhere on the infield, plus catcher, center field. Good base runner as well. The 2-0 pitch. Harp takes off speed, called a strike. Good pitching from Hudson. Five stolen bases tonight for the Bearcats. 2-0, Choa, Hafner, Chisholm, and now Frigier also with 1 apiece. An RBI situation for Clayton Harp. They call him Slim. Frigier dancing off second. Harp fouls it back. 2-2 the count. Two right-handed pitchers getting loose in the Abilene Christian bullpen. Frigier's at second base. Salazar shaded towards second a little bit to keep Frigier honest. 2-2 the count. And it's lined out to right field, a base hit. Frigier had to hold to make sure it made it past Smith. A one-out single from Hart. Now the pitching coach for Abilene Christian, Corey Vanderhook, out to the mound to have a word with his right-hander. They had 2 righties up and working, Jonathan Nicholson and Caleb Doherty. coach Brent Bono told me before the game, if things went according to the plan, they would use those two out of the bullpen after Hudson. Nicholson and Doherty both up and working. One of them will follow Hudson in this game. Jordan Cannon, a grand slam last night, looking for another big hit tonight. First and third, one out. 78 pitches so far for Garrett Hudson. First pitch, it's fouled back. Harp was off from first on the first pitch. Middle infield double play depth. Watts about halfway at third. First baseman Donahue on the back with Harp. A ground ball almost anywhere will give the Bearcats the lead, assuming it's not a double play. Fake to third, look to first, nothing doing. Many possibilities here for the Bearcats. They could try a squeeze play. Could send Harp from first. Or just let Cannon have a straightforward at bat. Cannon fouls it towards his dugout. 0-2. This is the longest outing this season so far. Garrett Hudson, he's matched it. He went 5 1/3 against New Orleans. He's gone 5 1/3 so far tonight. 0-2 the count. Good cut from Cannon, he fouled it back. Frazier at third, he singled. Harp at first base, he also had a base hit. Bearcats, 3-for-8 tonight with runners in scoring position. Abilene Christian is 0-for-6. Second straight night, the Wildcats have struggled in the clutch situations. 0-2 the count. Harp leads from first. He runs. Cannon bounces it weakly towards third. This will score a run. Watts has it, fires to first. Cannon is out. Close play. Cannon out at first base as Frazier scores the go-ahead run. Cannon can move. He's a fast-running catcher. Got out of the box quickly, but Watts has played a nice third base this season. Now it's the freshman, Jack Rogers. RBI opportunity, Harp at second base and two outs. Slider over the outside, nice pitch from Garrett Hudson. That's the 14th RBI of the season for Jordan Cannon. Four last night on his first career grand slam. Rogers has had a tough time tonight against Hudson. 0-for-2, caught looking his first time up, and he swung through a very good fastball in the fifth. Fastball runs inside. I think an opportunity for Matt Deggs to show Rogers some confidence. It's a very deep Bearcat team. They pinch hit a lot. Guys come off the bench all the time, but the fact the freshman's allowed to hit after two strikeouts against Hudson should put some confidence in the young first baseman. Good take that time on a good pitch down right below the knees. 2-1 the count. Two Bearcats. They've retaken the lead and looking for more with Rogers ahead in the count 2-1. Line drive towards second, bobbled there. by Smith, who recovers to throw to first in time. The inning is over. A dart off the bat of Rogers. Nice job by Smith to keep it on the infield. The Bearcats retake the lead. A good one in Huntsville. Here in the Southland, it's 3-2 Bearcats after six. Now the seventh inning. Matt Peterson with you from Huntsville, Texas. Sam Houston leading Abilene Christian 3-2 after the RBI ground out from Jordan Cannon. Gave the Bearcat the lead, a back and forth affair. 1-0 Abilene Christian after two. Bearcats tied it up and took the lead in the fifth. And both teams scored a single run last inning. Watts will lead off against Riley Gossett. And the first pitch is in there for a strike. Watts flew out to right field his first time. He walked his last trip. Swings and misses through a high fastball. Coach Britt Bono told me about Watts as when he does what he does well, hitting the ball on the ground, hitting the other way, bunting, etc., he can be very effective at the plate. And it's booted at second base by Trey Ochoa. A ground ball to his left. You're taught as a second baseman to get in front of it. Not every ground ball gives you that opportunity. Ochoa elected to field it to his left, and it ate him up. Ochoa has been very good at second base most of the season. First error of the ball game tonight, and first error of the series against Sam Houston State. Watts on first for Zach Mauser, the catcher. He tries to bunt and fouls it back to the screen. Just the second error of the season for Ochoa. Comes into this game with a 988 fielding percentage. Mauser unable to bunt, offered at that high pitch. Ochoa starting his 23rd game of the season tonight, and he's made just two errors. Third inning tonight, ACU has had the leadoff man aboard. And Mauser unable to get the bunt down. Tough assignment for the catcher. He's a defense first ball player. Asked to bunt there and he cannot execute.
Top of the order, left fielder number 7, Derek Scott.
One out for Derek Scott. Second strikeout for Riley Gossett. As Jay Sirianni goes out to the mound, and the Bearcats will make a call to the bullpen. A left-hander getting loose. Gossett, a big smile as he walks off the mound. Gossett two effective innings out of the bullpen. A new left-hander coming in for Sam Houston State. And it's Dominic Robinson, the lefty. 3-2 Bearcats, one out in the seventh.
Growing the growl is not just a saying or an expression. I take it as more of a Bearcat way.
It's time for everybody to get together. So anybody comes out, the community of Huntsville comes out and just get together, wear your orange.
To me, Grow the Growl is more than just letters on a stadium or words on a pamphlet. It's more about an overall feeling of spirit.
You make the commitment to come to Sam Houston. Commit all the way, 100%.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom by our student athletes.
Thank you for blessing me with this opportunity and your support so that our future Bearcats can continue our winning tradition.
Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
It's the eighth appearance of the season for Dominic Robinson, the sophomore lefty out of Tomball, Texas. Tomball Memorial High School for Dominic Robinson. And he comes on with one out in the top of the seventh in relief of Riley Gossett. Two effective innings for Mr. Gossett. Sakara started this game, then Gossett, and now Dominic Robinson. Top of the order for the fourth time tonight for Abilene Christian. Derek Scott is 0 for 3. Two flyouts and a strikeout. Lefty on lefty. Watts leads from first. And the first pitch misses. Robinson 1-0 with a 5.40 ERA. One start and six relief appearances this year. Fastball is low, 2-0. 10 hits allowed in 11 and two-thirds innings. 9 walks, 12 strikeouts. Another lefty, Colton Eager on deck. So a good spot to bring in Dominic Robinson. Fastball is high, 3-0. Robinson pitched twice last weekend against Dallas Baptist on Friday and Sunday. An outside strike. A total of four innings against DBU. Allowed one run on three hits. Had five strikeouts in the Sunday finale. So good stuff from Robinson 5 days ago. Runner goes from first, it's hammered, foul. Just past the new first baseman, Hunter Hearn. At the top of the inning, two defensive changes for Matt Deggs and the Bearcats. Hunter Hearn moved from right field to first base, replacing Jack Rogers. Riley McKnight is the new right fielder. The outfield looks like this, Harp, Bonner, McKnight, left to right. The infield from third to first is Hafner, Frigé, Ochoa, and Hearn. Cannon remains behind the plate. A good swing a moment ago from Scott. Now the count is full. Watts is running again, and there's the walk. He missed outside. Sixth walk issued by Bearcat pitchers after Sam Houston issued just one free pass last night. 2-1 with one out for Colton Eager. Eager had a similar spot in the fifth. Two in scoring position and two out, and he grounded out. That one gets away from Cannon. And that might be one of the differences between the teams. I would say if that ball got away from Mauser, the Abilene Christian catcher, a Bearcat base runner would try to take off in advance. But in that instance, Watts held it second. Watts, a freshman, maybe playing things a little conservative. 0-1 the count. Pitches outside, maybe a bit low. Watts at second, he reached on an error. Scott is at first after his walk. One out in the seventh, Bearcats leading 3-2. Robinson checks second. And that one gets away and both base runners will advance. A wild pitch from Robinson. And now the possible go-ahead runs in scoring position. Matt Degg said last weekend against DBU, Sam Houston not very clean on defense and with the pitching. A much better performance last night. Few walks, no errors. It's been a little bit sloppy for the Bearcats here in the middle innings. Everyone is back except for the third baseman, Hafner. Outside, 3-1. Fastball, curveball, and a changeup from Robinson. Oh, the Bearcats conceding a tying run, except for maybe Hafner, who's halfway at third. 3-1 pitch. Outside. Scott and Eager both walking. And that going against the blueprint for the Bearcats. Jay Sirianni out of the dugout. Robinson brought in to face two lefties. And he issues two walks. That's the end of the line for Robinson. Base is now loaded for Abilene Christian. And the new pitcher coming into this game is Dakota Mills. He's now the Bearcat closer. And he comes in to put out a fire in the seventh.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does Bear Bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite, hold true.
Dakota Mills, the senior closer, comes into this game. A big spot. As an error and two walks have loaded the bases for Abilene Christian. Mills has been dominant this season. Tonight will be his 10th appearance of the year. He has converted all five save opportunities. And that was a run of five straight appearances going into last weekend. 34 strikeouts against two walks. Opponents hitting 203 off the righty. And those 34 strikeouts and only 19 in the third innings. 1.86 earned run average. Mills, in his last six appearances, 26 strikeouts and two walks over 14 innings. He has been sensational. picked up a big save against Dallas Baptist last Saturday. After Clayton Harp homered in the bottom of the eighth for a 6-5 lead, Mills shut the door against DBU as the Bearcats won the middle game. First pitch to Farkas, slider bounced towards short. Frazier keeps it on the infield, throws wildly past second into right field. The tying and go-ahead run score. 4-3, Abilene Christian. A tough play for Frigier, but one where an out should have been made. May have rushed his throw towards second, throwing past Trey Ochoa. Farkas gets the job done on the very first pitch. Second error of the inning. Both middle infielders have made an error here in the seventh. Now it's Riley Donahue has been the best hitter for Abilene Christian this weekend in Huntsville. It scored a fielder's choice for Farkas. And we'll get an RBI and then the throwing error. Allows both Farkas and Eager to advance two bases. Mills hits the outside for strike one. Second lead of this game for Abilene Christian. They're now up 4-3. Fisted towards short. Frazier will make the catch. Nice pick from Mills in on the hands of Donahue in an RBI situation. Now two outs.
Shortstop number five, Robert Salazar.
Now it's Robert Salazar. Eager's at third, Farkas is at second. Slider drops low. Salazar is 0 for 3. A pop-up and two groundouts to short. Fastball hit out to left center field. Harp in the alley will make the catch. Mills does his job, gets a ground out, a pop out, and a fly out, but a critical error helps Abilene Christian take a 4-3 lead as we've reached the seventh inning stretch in Huntsville.
Texas.
Dalton Dunn is the new shortstop. He comes in to start the bottom of the seventh. Bearcats playing from behind. 4-3 Abilene Christian after they scored twice in the seventh. Eric Bonner takes the fastball for a strike. Garrett Hudson remains on the mound. I've mentioned this a few times, they're worth repeating. Brett Bono was hoping for four innings from Hudson. He is pitching into the seventh, and a fastball is low. 88 pitches so far for Hudson, his longest outing of the season. And 62 strikes out of the 88 pitches. Slider ripped into left center field. That's a base hit. Scott cannot cut it off. It's going to roll all the way to the wall. Bonnert runs well. He'll stop at second with the leadoff double. Bonnert having himself a nice series. Three hits last night, a couple steals, two hits tonight. Great swing from Bonnert. Waited back on that. His second double of the season. And now it's Trey Ochoa. This is Bearcat baseball. Whenever the opposition gets a lead, they're right on top of them. Ochoa squares to Bonnert. Goes all the way to the backstop. Nearly hit Ochoa and his bat. A mistake that time from Hudson on his 90th pitch of the evening. A wild pitch moves Bonnert to third. Coach Bono of ACU will leave the middle infielders back. The corners are about halfway. 1-0 pitch, stays high, 2-0. Hafner on deck and then Hearn, top of the Bearcat order. 4-3 Abilene Christian. They've scored four runs tonight on only two hits. This is hit out to center field. That will score the tying run. Munoz tracking it and he makes the catch. Ochoa gets the job done on 2-0. The sacrifice fly plates Bonnert, and it's 4-4 in Huntsville. Packed baseball right there. A double, a wild pitch, and a sacrifice fly. Thirteenth run batted into the year for Ochoa.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original.
Some sense of here we go again in that Abilene Christian dugout. They've had several leads in this weekend series. But the Bearcats keep fighting back. Hafner swinging at the first pitch, pops it up, and that will reach the Bearcat clubhouse. A short-lived 1-0 lead last night. The Bearcats scored the game's final 10 runs from the third to the seventh. Abilene Christian took a 1-0 lead in the second. The Bearcats tied it in the third. Sam Houston went ahead in the fifth. Abilene Christian tied it in the sixth, but Sam Houston went back in front in the bottom half. Fouled back again. Abilene Christian, two in the top of the seventh to take the lead, and the Bearcats quickly here in the bottom of the inning have tied it up. 0-2 on Ben Hafner, three hits tonight, two runs batted in, five RBIs so far this series. Hits it right back to the mound, off the glove of Hudson. He recovers, regathers, and throws to first. Hafner is 3-for-4. Base is empty, two outs for Hunter Hearn. Hearn is 0-for-3, a fielder's choice in the first. Led to a double play as he was out trying to take second when Ochoa was thrown out at home. He's also grounded out to short and flown out to left. Big cut from Hearn, he fouls it back. Activity continuing in the Abilene Christian bullpen. It's now only a left-hander getting loose. Earlier we saw Nicholson and Doherty both working. They should be ready. Hearn hits one high and deep to left, and that one is way out of here. A two-out homer for Hunter Hearn, and the Bearcats back in front, 5-4. The Bearcats are 7-0 in conference play for a resilient, for a reason. They are resilient. They will not back down. And they keep coming at you. Hearn his sixth homer of the season. The new team leader for the Bearcats. Bearcats up 5-4 as Chisholm stands in. Fastball misses low. And now the challenge for Abilene Christian. They have to face Dakota Mills, who is rested. Hasn't pitched since last Saturday. Pitched on 5 days rest. And the Bearcats back in front. Chisholm takes a fastball inside. Here's the swing from Hearn. A high kick, a bit of a bat flip from Hearn. He knew it was gone. Big stride from Hearn. He really generates so much power from his lower half. ...25th home run this season for the Bearcats. On 3-0, they find the outside part of the plate for 3-1. 25 homers and now 26 games, including tonight. Chisholm gives it a ride out to left center field. Munoz in the alleyway will make the catch. The Bearcats respond. Two in the top half for Abilene Christian, two in the bottom half for the Bearcats. A sack fly from Trey Ochoa, and a no doubt about it, solo shot from Hunter Hearn. To the eighth, 5-4 Bearcats. Top of the eighth inning in Huntsville. Bearcats leading 5-4 in a back and forth ball game. First pitch to Munoz, misses inside. Munoz 1-for-3, a single in the second. Since then, a fly out to left and an RBI ground out. It's foul back. Dakota Mills fully capable of closing this game out. He got the final two outs in a clutch situation last inning. He gave up the ground ball, which gave Abilene Christian the run on the throwing error from Frigier, but he got the next two outs as Munoz skies this out to left center. Bonnard in the alley will leave it for Harp. Munoz is 1-for-4. Now Zach Smith. Mills has gone seven innings twice this season, or pitched into the seventh. Now is Smith ready. Takes a strike. Beg your pardon, that was last year. Mills, mostly a starter. This year, he's gone five innings. That was against Prairie View. Fastball runs inside, it's a called strike. But Mills fully capable of getting the final eight outs of this game. He's already got two and now six to go. Fastball is high. One of those six recorded on the fly out to left. Smith 0 for 2 with a walk and an RBI ground out. Swing and a miss. Smith down on strikes. First strikeout for Dakota Mills. Mills against DBU on a Saturday. Two strikeouts as he picked up his fifth straight save. Watts takes strike one. Five saves in his last five appearances for Dakota Mills. He would now be in position for the win if he can hold on to this 5-4 Bearcat lead. Working quickly and getting ahead of hitters. 1-2 on Watts. Watts 0 for 2 with the walk, and he's reached on an error. Swing and a miss. He blows him away with the fastball. Dakota Mills has been electric out of the bullpen. Retires the side in order in the eighth with two strikeouts. Caleb Doherty, the new pitcher for Abilene Christian. And let's look back at the top of the inning. The last two outs recorded by Dakota Mills. Running fastball in on the hands and then a challenge fastball across the belt. He gets Smith and Watts. Now Mills dominant all year. And he could close out this ball game in the ninth. Doherty in and relief of Hudson, who pitched pretty well. His final line, 7 innings, 9 hits, 5 runs, 4 earned, no walks, 3 strikeouts. He threw 102 pitches. And one of his last pitches was the go-ahead home run from Hunter Hearn. First pitch swinging, Frigier fouls it back. Frigier tonight, 1 for 3, singled and scored in the sixth. That bounces in the dirt. Well, this game has somewhat gone to script for Britt Bono, the head coach of Abilene Christian in his 22nd year. He was hoping to get 4 innings out of his starter. He got 7. He was hoping to use Nicholson and Knowles at some point tonight. He uses Doherty here in the eighth as it bounces on top of the roof. Good effort from Watts. But Doherty has been a very good pitcher in his own right. 2-1 on the year, 2.29 ERA. It's his ninth appearance of the year. 24 strikeouts, only 3 walks issued in 19 2/3 innings. Visit to the mound from the catcher, Mauser. Coach Bono said it. Doherty's done a tremendous job in long relief. He can go three or four innings at a time. Could be a closer for these Wildcats or a starter down the line. A fifth-year senior for Abilene Christian. Breaking ball is bounced softly foul right towards the Bearcat logo on the first base side. Fastball between 88 and 92 miles an hour for Doherty. A good two-seam fastball that sinks. 1-2 on Frigier. Chest off the plate. And Doherty thought that was strike three. Coach Bono said, Doherty has a weird fastball. It moves left and right. Doherty pitching with a lot of confidence right now, takes a deep breath and comes home. Another foul ball from Frigier towards the ACU bullpen. And caught by one of the bullpen catchers down there. A seesaw affair. Multiple lead changes and both teams with two runs in the seventh. Frigier, a high chopper, tough play towards short, fielded by Salazar. Throw to first is low and not caught by Donahue. An infield hit for Frigier. Right off the bat, you knew that would be a tough play for Salazar. Frigier runs well, hustled the whole way out of the box. Singles in his last two at-bats for Frigier. It was now 2-for-4. Now it's Slim standing in. Clayton Harp. Takes a changeup low. Harp singled in the sixth. Also a fly out to deep center and grounded out to third. Caleb Doherty comes home. Frigier's running and it's tapped foul at the first base line. Now Frigier stole second in the sixth inning. Bearcats as a team very aggressive on the bases tonight. Five steals and yet to be caught. Last year, these teams met in Abilene as the Bearcats rolled to a 10-0 start to the Southland Conference season a year ago. 1-1 pitch is a base hit to right, right between first and second. Frigier stops at second. It's bobbled in right, and now Frigier will try for third. He'll make it. Back into first safely is Hart. A fielding error from Colton Eager, the right fielder. Nice recognition from Frigier. He stopped at second, but immediately moved to third once he saw the bobble in right field. Fourth error of the night committed by Abilene Christian. Sixth of the series against the Wildcats. Corey Vanderhook, the pitching coach, goes out to the mound to talk it over with Caleb Doherty. Senior out of Keller, Texas, and Keller High School, pitched at McClellan Community College before Abilene Christian. I mentioned that 10-0 start in conference play. That included a sweep at Abilene Christian right around this time last year. It was March 31st and April 1st, a Friday night and a Saturday doubleheader, and they're going to make the call to the bullpen. Ryan Knowles is coming in. A junior out of Jacksonville, Florida. 5-4 Bearcats. 2-1, nobody out. Knowles coming in.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
At HEB, we are all about Texas beef because we're dedicated to supporting local Texas ranchers, like Dr. Charles Graham from Gonzales, Texas.
I've always loved working ranch animals, so I became a veterinarian to ensure my cattle got the best care 24/7. They need lots of TLC, and I'll make sure to get it.
Ranchers like Dr. Graham are why HEB buys more Texas beef than anyone else. This is the best Texas beef department at HEB. No store does more than my HEB.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Ryan Knowles, the new pitcher for Abilene Christian. Fourteenth appearance out of the bullpen, the most used reliever on this Abilene Christian team. 1-0 with the 4.24 ERA. 13 strikeouts, 8 walks, 20 hits allowed in those 17 innings. Well, Knowles, one of the pitchers that Coach Britt Bonow of Abilene Christian wanted to get in the game behind. A starting pitcher, Garrett Hudson. Jordan Cannon seems like he's come up with the runner on base in almost every at bat this weekend. First and third, nobody out, and Knowles looks at each base runner. Cannon 0 for 3 tonight, but an RBI ground out his last time up. Now the sidearmer fakes to third once again. Cannon gave the Bearcats a brief lead, but the RBI ground out in the sixth. Bearcats have retaken the lead at 5-4. Good sidearm pitch is swung on a miss by Cannon. Frazier is at third, he singles. Harp also at first base after a base hit. The Bearcats with 11 hits tonight. They had 12 hits last night. Oh, and one the count. Blocked by Mauser. One of the keys to this game, clutch hitting. Bearcats 3-for-10 with runners in scoring position. Abilene Christian 0-for-9. Cannon pops it up behind first. Donahue hoping for a play, and it's onto the berm. Abilene Christian, 4 runs on 2 hits. They've benefited from 7 walks they've drawn against the Bearcats. And 2 critical Sam Houston State errors, which both came in the 7th. As Abilene Christian took a brief 4-3 lead. And that hit Cannon. The most often hit batter on this Bearcat team. He loads the bases. On the back of his left leg. Jackson Grisham now is going to pinch hit. Riley McKnight's spot is due up in the order after he came in as a defensive replacement to play right field after they lifted Rogers. Base is loaded, nobody out. The infield comes in for Abilene Christian. And Grisham takes a first pitch for a strike. Grisham came off the bench last night. He's 0 for 1, hitting 231 on the year. 5-4 Bearcats, base is loaded, nobody out. Two singles and a hit batter. Swing and a miss, 0-2. Jordan Cannon has now been hit by a pitch 12 times this year. As Grisham comes over to talk with Matt Deggs. Cannon entered this weekend series the eighth most hit batter in all of NCAA baseball. 12 times Cannon has now been hit by a pitch. That's all part of getting on base. And Coach Matt Deggs said, if we can get our on-base percentage closer to 400, it will be a very dangerous team. Sam Houston State entered this game at 381 as a team on-base percentage. Grisham is caught looking at fastball away. First out in the eighth. Now it's Eric Bonner. Bonner getting his second straight start. His second and third starts of the year this weekend. He's been very good. Five hits in the first two games of this series. He doubled and scored in the seventh. Jump started the rally last inning. Came in to score on the sac fly from Ochoa, which tied the game. Good block from Mauser on a pitch in the dirt. And the Bearcats at 381 team on base percentage. If they can get to 400, which is one of Matt Deggs' goals, with the power on this team and the consistency in the order, they should be able to score even more runs. 1-0 the count with one out. And it's fouled off the end of the bat. The Bearcats with the home run from Hunter Hearn tonight have now hit 25 homers through 26 games, including this evening. Last year's Bearcat team, which reached the first super regional in program history, those Bearcats hit 31 homers in 67 games, basically one every other game. Bonner fouls it back. Bearcats gave up 53 homers last year. The on-base percentage for the Bearcats a year ago, 394 as a team. The team slugged 416 as a group. This year's team at 439 has a team slugging percentage. So more power, better slugging, not as good on base yet. Bonner takes outside, it's 2-2. Bearcat team ERA this year as a pitching staff is 3.36, last year's 3.80. So the pitching has been better as a whole. 2-2 pitch, head out to center field. Bonner gets the job done. Munoz will make the catch. Tagging from third is Frigier. He will score the insurance run for the Bearcats. Good at bat from the freshman, Eric Bonner. Abilene Christian appeals to third to see if Frigier left early. He did not. As Chris Booker, the home run umpire, waves his arm at the safe side. Here's Trey Ochoa. Second RBI of the season for Eric Bonner. Now it's Trey Ochoa, two on and two out. Ochoa had a game-tying sacrifice fly last inning. 6-4 Bearcats, both runners go, the pitch is inside. A double steal for the Bearcats. Good call for Matt Deggs. You know, with the side armor up there, he might try a swing through on the first pitch or something off the plate. And the aggressive call works out. A double steal with two outs. That's Pac Baseball. Harp up to third, Cannon up to second. Ochoa lifts it to right, eager towards the line, and the inning is over. Dakota Mills now with two runs to work with. We go to the top of the ninth. Bearcats trying to go to 8-0 in Southland Conference play. It's the ninth inning in Huntsville, Texas. The Bearcats lead 6-4. Three unanswered runs to turn a 4-3 deficit into a 6-4 lead. A few defensive changes for the Bearcats. Mac Odom will play right field. Now it's Odom, Bonner, and Harp right to left in the outfield. Hearn, Ochoa, Frigé, Hafner first to third in the infield. And Jordan Cannon will work with Dakota Mills. 9-1-2 in the order due up. They're going to pinch hit for Zach Mauser. It will be Nolan Ritchie to bat for the first time this weekend. Nolan Ritchie, 7 hits and 29 at bats this year, a 241 hitter. Ritchie against Dakota Mills. And as you can see, Mills is ready to work. Swing and a miss. Spoke with pitching coach Jay Sirianni about Dakota Mills and his transformation as a shutdown closer this year. 0-2. He said the new role has simplified his approach. Now he'll work one or two, maybe three innings in a game. Last year as a starter, we'll have to go through the order two or three times. Swing and a miss. Ritchie down on three pitches. Three straight strikeouts for Dakota Mills. Top of the order, Derek Scott will now bat. He's 0-for-3 today, walked and scored in the seventh. Pitches low. Mills knows now as the closer, he can just empty the tank, throw his best stuff. And Coach Sirianni said his stuff hasn't changed much this year to last. 1-1. And he said one thing that's always been true with Mills is you have to beat him. He's always around the plate, has never walked too many hitters. Slider misses inside. Always been a strike thrower. And he said Dakota Mills has embraced the role as the new closer for the Bearcats. 3-1. He joked that Mills can now goof off for five or so innings in the bullpen and then come in and do his job and close out the game. And there is a rare walk issued by Mills. That brings the tying run to the plate in Colton Eager. Just the third walk issued in over 21 innings by Dakota Mills. Colton Eager ready from the left side. Fouls it back. Eager's 0 for 3. Couple flyouts. He walked his last time, had a big opportunity with two in scoring position and two outs in the fifth, but grounded out against Riley Gossett, a big spot in the game. And on the hands, grounded softly towards Ochoa, tries for the swipe tag, throws to first, not in time. Good hustle from Eager, and he beats it out. Ochoa trying for the double play. And no out is recorded, an infield hit from Eager. Tough play for Ochoa. I don't blame him for trying for the swipe tag. You're so close and you almost get that first out recorded as we take another look. But I think what really cost him was how long it took him to get the ball out of his mitt and out of his hands. He had to double clutch on the throw. First pitch swung on and missed by Farkas. If he doesn't double clutch, good chance they get Eager. Well, Farkas has been dangerous tonight. Two deep flyouts, his first two at-bats against Gabriel Sequeira. 6-4 Bearcats. The 0-1, foul back. Farkas, 3 homers on the season. Fastball is outside, 1-2. Six, 4 Bearcats. They've scored the game's last 3 runs. Mills comes home. Check swing to LaPeel. He did not swing. 2-2 the count. First base umpire Chad Rogers siding with the hitter. Whew. Could have been a swing. 2 balls, 2 strikes the count. Runners go. And the pitch is popped up behind first. Here comes Hearn, hoping for a play. And it's onto the berm. A rare instance in which Abilene Christian put the runners in motion. They've really struggled with runners on base this entire series. 0 for 9 with runners in scoring position. Tonight, 3 for 15 with runners on base this evening. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here comes Mills. Slider outside, nice block from Cannon. He's gonna throw back to first. Now they have 2 base runners in a tough situation. Mills will cover first. Ochoa will flip to Mills and they tag out the back base runner, Eager. A scoring base running mistake from Abilene Christian. The possible tying run is out on the bases. Colton Eager caught between first and second. Scott takes third. And now Mills is just 1 strike away from closing out this game. Some indecisiveness. We've seen it throughout this game from Abilene Christian on the bases. It was a big secondary lead from Scott. And I think the back base runner, Eager, thought he might go to third, so he moved towards second. Now Matt Deggs goes out to the mound. Talk things over with Dakota Mills. A short talk and smiles from the infielders. Frege and Hafner on the left, Hearn and Ochoa on the right. It's a young ball club, Abilene Christian. They have some older experience with a lot of junior college players. But Colton Eager, a freshman, tagged out after being caught in a rundown. And look at big Dakota Mills hustling over. Ochoa thought about the tag, and a tag on the forehead. Here's the 3-2, foul back, big swing from Farkas. Abilene Christian has committed 4 errors, a few base running mistakes. that's still in it to the final at bat. Here's the 3-2. Foul back by Farkas. Riley Donahue, a very good left-handed batter, would be next for Abilene Christian. Mills has thrown 32 pitches and recorded 7 outs. Scott leads from third. Mills reads the sign. Here it comes. And it's hit high and deep out to left and gone. A game-tying home run from Dallin Farkas. And the Bearcats, for the third time this season at home, down to the final stripe to close out a game, and the visiting team has tied it up or gone ahead. What an at-bat from Farkas, who gets mobbed on his way to the dugout. Fourth home run for the DH Farkas, who was at the plate when Eager was caught at first in a rundown. Great swing from Farkas, no doubt about it. And now it's Jay Sirianni to the mound to grab the baseball from Dakota Mills. Resilience from this Abilene Christian team. Entering the game for the Bearcats is Riley Cooper, one of the stars from last postseason. 6-6 in the ninth. We'll be back to Huntsville.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom. Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
I know my life is going to be in a better place after I graduate because of the donors who give me their endowment each year.
The Bearcat Champions Fund, building champions.
Riley Cooper, the senior out of Texas City, comes into this game. Top of the ninth inning, Abilene Christian has battled back a 2-run shot from Dallin Farkas. That's the first home run allowed all season by Dakota Mills in over 21 innings. Well, of course, we're due for another tie. This game has been tied 1-1, 2-2. 3-3, 4-4, and now 6-6. And 9 of the game's 12 runs have been scored from the 7th inning on. Riley Donahue will bat with the bases empty and 2 outs. Dallin Farkas extending the game with a full count, 2 out, 2-run homer. Credit him for fouling off a few pitches before the homer. First pitch to Donahue's in there for a strike. Donahue has walked, singled, grounded out, and popped up. Spins out of the way of one that's called a strike. A sweeping breaking ball from Riley Cooper. Strike three. Cooper strikes out Donahue on 3 pitches. Sensational from Cooper, who's fired up as he heads back to the dugout. pitcher into the ball game for Abilene Christian, Derek Scott. And he has the bottom of the ninth. Sixth appearance out of the bullpen for Scott. 0-1 with the 5.40 ERA, one save, 15 hits allowed in 11 2/3 innings. 9 strikeouts and 4 walks. Hafner, Hearn, and Chisholm do up 2, 3, and 4 in the Bearcats order. You don't want to overemphasize one out, but baseball is a game of momentum. Some might dispute that. I think it can be within a game, clearly. And all the momentum seemed to be in that Abilene Christian dugout after the 2-run homer from Dallin Farkas. But Riley Cooper comes out of the bullpen, a senior with some big time experience, and he struck out Riley Donahue on 3 pitches, including an 0-1 curveball that Donahue bent out of the way of. And he was pumped as he came off the mound. And I think the momentum's back in the Bearcat dugout. Striking out the cleanup hitter on 3 pitches, and now the Bearcats will bat as they try to win the ball game at 6-6. Hafner takes a strike over the outside. Ben Hafner, 3-for-4, singles in his first 3 trips to the plate. A couple of RBIs, he grounded back to the pitcher his last time. Good curveball drops in there for a strike. Curveball is fouled off. Garrett Hudson went 7 innings to start things for Abilene Christian. Then it was Doherty and Knowles to follow. Now it's Scott. And the count is 1-2. Abilene Christian doesn't have a fully defined closer. Nicholson, I think, would be used if they have a lead in this game, but it's 6-6. It turned to Scott. Breaking ball bounced down the right field line. Donahue takes it to the bag himself. And there's one out. Hafner, 3-for-5. Hunter Hearn will stand in now.
First baseman number 8, Hunter Hearn.
It gave the Bearcats a lead in the 7th on this swing. First pitch swinging. Here in the 8th, he pops it up into right field, and it's caught. Now Eager makes the catch. And Hearn is retired, 1-for-5. That was Hearn's team leading 6th homer of the year. Now it's Blake Chisholm. Now I mentioned Nicholson will likely close out any game this weekend if they have the lead. The problem is he might start tomorrow's game. So I think Coach Britt Bono of Abilene Christian wants to make sure he has a lead before he uses Nicholson. Chisholm takes the strike. If they use Nicholson, he obviously can't start tomorrow's game. 1 p.m. first pitch here in Huntsville. Fastball is high to Chisholm, 1-1. Chisholm, a rare 0-for tonight. A ground out, 2 fly outs, and he's reached on an error. 1-1 the count. Up and in, 2 balls and a strike. 6 runs, 11 hits, 2 errors, 7 left on for the Bearcats. 6 runs, 4 hits, 4 errors, 7 left for Abilene Christian. Fastball misses, now a hitter's count. 3-1 for Chisholm, who has home run power. loves to go to the opposite field. 3-1 the count. Scott has his sign. Here it comes. Fastball right there. Andrew Frigier on deck. Bottom of the ninth. Abilene Christian tied it up. A two-run homer from Dallin Farkas in the top of the inning. Chisholm takes strike three. A breaking ball to the outside part of the plate. And we will go to extra innings in Huntsville. Riley Cooper returns to the mound for the 10th inning. Abilene Christian tied it up, a two-run homer from Dallin Farkas on a 3-2 pitch with two outs and the top of the ninth. First homer allowed by Dakota Mills all season. Sixth appearance for Riley Cooper. 3.24 earned run average and a favorite in that clubhouse. Memorable last year in the postseason. And some of the press conferences for Matt Deggs. So much praise for Riley Cooper, including two wins at Texas Tech in the Lubbock Regional on back-to-back days. The pitch is outside. 1-0 on Salazar, the Abilene Christian shortstop. He's 0-for-4 today. Cooper last year in the Lubbock Regional, 3 2/3 innings on June 4th, 4 2/3 innings the next day. Fastball's outside. Bearcats beat the Red Raiders in each instance. That's over the inside for a strike. He then went to the Tallahassee Regional through four more innings, gave up only two runs. He also threw 2 1/3 innings against Arizona earlier in the Lubbock Regional. Make that 14 total innings in the postseason last year. Swing and a miss, he gets Salazar. Back-to-back strikeouts for Cooper. Struck out Donahue on three pitches to end the Abilene Christian half of the ninth. First pitch called a strike. Taken by Munoz, who is 1-for-4. A single is first at bat, an RBI ground out in the sixth. That's over the outside, 0-2. On Munoz. Cooper likes to work quickly, has his sign from Cannon. And it's lifted out to shallow right center. Bonner makes the catch. They call him Coop.
Second baseman, 19 sacks.
for a large part of last season, more of a situational lefty. But his role grew significantly in the postseason a year ago. Fastball's outside. The Bearcats were in the loser's bracket at the Lubbock Regional, so out of necessity, they have to play extra innings, and Cooper was called upon. Good changeup, swung on and missed. Zach Smith badly fooled. 0-for-3 today with the walk. Swing and a miss. Coach Sirianni calls his breaking pitch a sweeper. Also throws a sinker. 1-2 with two outs. Riley Cooper trying to get the Bearcats to the bottom of the 10th, and he does. Three strikeouts. And 1 1/3 innings for Riley Cooper, the Bearcats, with a chance to win it when we come back to Huntsville. Bottom of the 10th inning now from Huntsville. I'm Matt Peterson. Been a fun game, 6-6 in the bottom of the 10th. Frege, Harp, and Cannon do up against Derek Scott, who worked a perfect bottom of the 9th with the strikeout. Good curveball misses up and in, 1 ball, no strikes. Scott struck out Chisholm, looking to end the 9th. Lefty on righty. Frege squares to butt and takes ball two. Frege's 2-for-4. Infield singles each of the last two trips. Frege taps it foul right to Matt Deggs. Bearcats trailed 4-3 going to the bottom of the 7th. They got 2 runs, including a go-ahead homer from Hunter Hurd. Abilene Christian tied it up with a 2-run shot from Dallin Farkas off Dakota Mills on the top of the 9th. Frege pops it foul towards the first base berm. Abilene Christian, 6 runs and only 4 hits tonight. Bearcats trying to improve to 8-0 in the Southland after a 10-0 start in league play last year. Curveball stays high. Last year, the Bearcats reached double-digit runs in all 3 games in Abilene. Wins of 13-3, 14-3, and 19-12. Almost a year to the date a year ago. There's a walk. Frege reaches base for the 3rd straight time. Frege's been patient this series. That's his 3rd base on balls drawn. And that's the 1st walk drawn tonight by the Bearcats after they drew 8 free passes last night. Darian Sims is going to pinch hit now. He'll bat for Harp. Might be asked to bunt. Good speed. A speedy outfielder. At first, a visit to the mound. And Britt Bono. 22nd year as head coach at Abilene Christian. Sims came off the bench as a pinch runner last night. Hitting 265 on the year. Two sacrifice bunts so far this year. Middle infield playing for two. Third baseman is up 3 feet on the infield dirt. And it's popped up high in the air by Sims, and that's gonna reach the dugout. Borland, the new catcher, gave his best effort. A full leap from Lane Borland, who replaced Mauser, who was pinch hit for in the late innings. Lane Borland, the sophomore out of Abilene and Wiley High School. Could have been spectacular if he came up with that catch. A first bunt attempt for Sims, unsuccessful. That's a much better bunt. Back towards the mound. And a safe out taken by Scott. Now Sims gets the job done. Frigier up to second into scoring position. Nice job from Sims. Now it's Jordan Cannon. I mentioned earlier how many opportunities Cannon's had in RBI situations last night and tonight. Had the Grand Slam yesterday, first of his career. An RBI opportunity for Cannon. He batted with Chisholm on third base in the fourth and struck out. An RBI ground out in the sixth with two on and two out in the eighth. He was hit by a pitch and now he'll be intentionally walked. It was fourth straight at bat in an RBI situation. They're gonna put him on. There's ball two. Jackson and Grisham is the man due up next, but Chase Cryer is getting loose in the on deck circle. Ball three misses. And there's ball four. Jackson Grisham. Cryer started last night's game, was 0 for 2 with a run score. Having a good year, hitting 347 on the year. Eight doubles, two homers. A single to the outfield could win the game with Frigier's speed at second. Change up in the dirt, ball one. The Bearcats' last walk-off win. Hunter Hurd is game-winning homer against Vanderbilt down at Minute Maid Park. This is bounced towards third, fielded there by Watts. He goes to second for one, no relay. Took Smith an extra second to get out of his glove. He may not have thrown it anyway. Cannon is forced at second, Frigier up to third. And Cryer aboard on the fielder's choice. Here's Eric Bonner, a big spot for the freshman who's had a great series. Three hits last night, two hits tonight, including an RBI sacrifice fly in the eighth, which gave the Bearcats a needed insurance run. He's also doubled and scored twice. Bonner takes off speed for ball one. 6-6 in the bottom of the 10th. Frege walked, he's at third. Kenny was intentionally walked, he's at first. That misses low. Pretty ordinary defense across the outfield and infield for Abilene Christian. 2-0 with two outs. Three and oh on Bonner. Trey Ochoa, dangerous leadoff man, would be next for the Bearcats. Derek Scott comes set. Breaking ball over the inside. Three balls and one strike. 6-6 in the 10th. Ball four, Bonner bluffed a bunt. It may have been on if that was in the strike zone, but he draws a walk. Second walk of the inning, actually the third. The second unintentional walk of the inning plus the intentional free pass to Cannon. Trey Ochoa now, 1-for-4, singles in the first. A sacrifice fly in the seventh. He flew out his last time. 26 pitches so far for Scott. Activity in the bullpen. Looks like two right-handers getting loose for Abilene Christian. Ochoa bluffs a bunt. It's almost to the backstop. Lane Borland, the new catcher, had to come out of his crouch. Scott will come from the windup. Ochoa bluffs a bunt and takes a strike. Watts is even with the bag at third. First baseman Donahue stays back. Outfield is straight away. Here's the pitch. And it's high. 2-1 on Ochoa. Frege the winning run at third base. Nowhere to put Ochoa. 6-6 in the bottom of the 10th. Scott comes home. Ball three. Ochoa, very patient. One more ball and the Bearcats will win. Here it comes. And the count is full. Full count, two outs in the 10th. The runners will be off, including Frege from third. Biggest pitch of the night, right here. Foul back by Ochoa. And two the count. Scott has his side. Here it comes. Ball four. The ball game is on. Ochoa walks. Frege scores, and the Bearcats stay perfect in Southland Conference play. A 7-6 win. No lead seems safe against the Bearcats. And when they fall behind, they're so good at rallying, especially here at Don Sanders Stadium. A 4-3 lead in the seventh was not safe for Abilene Christian. And even after a game tying home run from Dallin Farkas in the ninth, the Bearcats rally with the run in the 10th. And they do it on four walks. Frazier, Cannon, Bonner, and Ochoa, each with a walk. Cannon's was intentional. And that's how the Bearcats win tonight, 7-6. 13th RBI of the season for Trey Ochoa. Excellent work out of the bullpen from Riley Cooper, a senior. Gets his first win of the year. He's 1-1 and picks up Dakota Mills, who gave up the game-tying home run in the ninth. Scott is the losing pitcher. The Bearcats improved to 19-7 on the year, 8-0 in the Southland, 2 wins shy of last year's 10-0 start in Southland Conference play. Abilene Christian's 13-11, 2-9 in the Southland. The series finale is tomorrow at 1 p.m. I'm Matt Peterson saying so long from Don Sanders Stadium. Well, the final score is Sam Houston State 7, Abilene Christian 6 in 10 innings. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on our family of ESPN networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.